Are we on?
We're on.
Hey guys, this is Rick. I hope you're having a great day. I'm outside and I'm with Austin.
Where?
Yay!
Oh, yeah.
We've come camping and we're in this beautiful little site. What's the name of it? Bracelands.
Forest of Dean.
In the Forest of Dean. And I was a bit worried because I wanted to use the telescope and I thought forest, that's all going to be covered in, you know, with trees, but it's
sky.
Absolutely beautiful. It's completely open and we're going to have a cracking view of the stars tonight. If you look up at that sky, it's been like that all day.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
And it's absolutely fantastic.
It's been nice in the sun. It's been really nice in the sun.
I was amazed.
Freezing
it's,
out of.
It's sort of freezing cold, but warm in the sun, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
It's going to be -3 tonight, so I'm going to try to do stargazing as early on in the night as I can, because the temperature, the temperature's going
to
be like 0 down to about 7 o'clock, and then it's going to start dropping. So by about like midnight, it's going to be -3. So I'm going to try to get as much stargazing as done as I can before that happens. I'm starting to set up now, and that's just the tripod. We've just got the tripod facing north, which is that way, and that's where the North Star is going to be up there somewhere. And I'll tell you what I have done though, is I was wondering if I could video log while I'm doing viewing. I'm not sure whether I'm going to do that tonight, because literally I'm setting this up outside for the first time tonight. Yeah, I've not actually used the telescope. I've set it up a few times, I've learned how to set it up, but I've not actually properly used it under the stars yet. So I'm going to do that tonight. So I'm probably not going to film that, because obviously I'm going to want to concentrate on that. But what I've done is I've made an infrared camera. Basically, this is my sister's old snappy camera, and she's just got a new one for Christmas. So I managed to scrounge her old one off of her, and I've converted it over to read infrared. And I've actually got a video on how I did that going up. It's either up already or it's going up shortly. And so this is like now an infrared camera, which will see in the dark as long as you've got some sort of infrared illumination. So I got an infrared illuminator, and basically this whole rig can sit on a tripod somewhere, and it's all run off 12 volts. So this plugs into a 12 volt source, and that will pilot or power the illuminator, and then you've got a USB thing here, and that'll power the camera. And so hopefully you will be able to see.
Looks like something out of a space
shuttle,
doesn't it?
Doing at night. Yeah, well it's sort of like a crude
is that from one of the Apollo missions?
It's more like a crude security camera, really.
It's a cracking idea though, isn't it?
But it's a great idea. I found there's loads and loads of videos on how to convert cameras over to infrared. And if you've just got an old camera sat in the bottom drawer somewhere.
You managed to take that one apart all right then?
Yeah,
tried it and I destroyed the camera.
I was very careful. I had to hold it back together again with sellotape.
Oh, yeah.
But I bought me a really big jacket because I'm going to need that tonight. And
Ellie stays in the van.
Ellie stays in the van, yeah, because I don't want to jumping up on it. Yeah. I bought a heater for the van, so at some point I'm going to plug that in, and so this will be my little warm cubby hole, which I can retreat to every now and again and warm up, and then come back out and do a bit more stargazing. That's the theory. Whether it works like that or not, I don't know. But for now, I'm just going to set the tripod up, let it get acclimatized to the cold. It was interesting driving down here. One of the things that I wanted to do was to make sure that I could go camping and have all the telescope gear with me, and it was piled up here while I drove down. But obviously at night time I can keep it all in the cab, so you know it's going to work. And so far it's kind of worked out well. So anyway, I'm going to get set up, and no doubt I'll come back to you a bit later. Okay, right. I've sort of got all my thermal curtains on with all my little silver bits ready for the night. It's getting pretty cold, hence the weird hat. The telescope's out, the sun has set, and it's looking rather splendid. And I'm hoping that at some point very, very soon, we're going to be getting to see the North Star. Now, the one thing that is concerning me a little bit is there's a mist hanging over everything, so I'm hoping I will actually be able to see some decent stars tonight. But the scopes are set up as much as I can get it set up until tonight. I basically need to line it up with the North Star before I do anything, but I can't do that until I can see the North Star, so it's going to be a little while. And that's going to give me a bit of time to have some tea, so I shall do that. What I have got going is, I'll show you the little setup I've got. Because I'm on mains hookup, it means I don't have to use the battery to operate the telescope. I can actually operate it from the mains. So I've got basically a mains power lead going into this 12 volt box here, which the lead's coming out. There we go. And that goes into like a little 12 volt cigarette lighter socket, which goes along here to this little 12 volt splitter, and this gives me the opportunity to plug in more things as well as some USB bits and pieces, and then that obviously goes up and that goes into the scope. So it's all been operated off of the 240 volts. Oh dear, I've just realized this is lit up, so I may have to stick a cloth or something over that because it's going to kill my night vision. So I didn't realize these things lit up. I'll cross that bridge if I get to it. But right now I haven't had anything to eat all day, so I'm going to go in and get warm. Got my little heater going. It's putting out quite a bit of heat as well. I'm going to have my tea, so I'll see you later.
Am I on?
You are.
I'm very, very bright.
Really? How about back here?
Yeah, very bright.
Cool.
Yeah, it comes out really well.
Right, so we've got the infrared camera on.
Hold on, let's twiddle you to the left a bit. There you are, you're in it now.
Alright, okay. I'm just looking at something called the Flaming Star Nebula.
Mm.
It's a big bunch of stars. I finally managed to get this thing sussed out. It was took a little bit of a couple of attempts to get it lined up, but get some amazing shots of real kind of deep space going on there. I'd love to photograph it for you, but I can't because I haven't got the right equipment. But hopefully that'll change soon. This is amazing. We've just seen the Andromeda galaxy. It's like an actual galaxy. It's well cool.
I'm very impressed with this camera, actually. This infrared, this works really well because I can't see you hardly.
Really?
At all.
This little camera, it's only a little rubbishy old thing. It's like even got in this in 4:3 format. It's so old. But I've got a little 4-LED ultraviolet spotlight, and it lights everything up. Actually, I'm curious how far.
No, they can't. No, that's it.
How far away can I get?
If I cover you up, you can't see nothing.
What about now? Can you still see me?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
No way.
Infrared light spectrum travels a long way, doesn't it?
I'm up on the path. Can you see me now?
Yeah, I still see you.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. I won't go any further because I... So there we go. Now we know it works.
Yeah, it's cracking, isn't it?
The object? Yes. Let me go see the Flame Nebula. Ooh. How are you doing there, Austin? All right?
I'm still here.
Cold?
My hands are cold. Well, actually, no, not too bad.
How about California Nebula?
Oh.
Whatever that is.
Sounds interesting.
Never heard of that one.
It's very clever how this moves around, isn't it?
I'm glad...
It all knows its stuff
I'm
now.
I'm glad it knows what it's doing, because I haven't got a clue.
Yeah. This metal bracket's cold.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
We're going to make a cup of tea in a bit.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
I'll have to dip my fingers in the cup to thaw them out.
It's going to be -3 tonight. That's going to be fun.
-3.
It's a nice dark sky, though.
I don't know if I can show the ground, actually. That's very bright, but can you see down there how crispy that is?
Oh, also, I take it you can't see that because we're looking at the Milky Way up there. It's actually the gaseous edge of the Milky Way because it's really dark here.
Oh wow! There's a nebula.
Nebula.
I can't. It's very, very faint.
What does it say? Does that come up? Does that LED pick up on there? Can you read what it says?
Oh.
Does that have interest?
It's too bright.
No, it doesn't. No. The infrared knocks it out. Look, you can't
read
it.
Oh, I see. It's completely gone. That's interesting.
Blank.
Ah.
But if it wasn't infrared, it would say. What does it say?
It says Crab Nebula.
Crab Nebula.
Let me focus it.
It's funny because it's like watching it in black and white.
There you go, I can see it's just a tiny little grey smudge. You can have a look if you want. The camera won't get it. Do you want to have the camera anyway?
I'll have a look.
I'll film you having a look, how's that?
Film me having a look.
But we'll go to Andromeda because that was really bright.
That's a cracking smudge.
Where are we? Beehive. Andromeda, right. So if we go to the Andromeda galaxy. View objects, yes please. Take a moment to slew round, I think. And then, go and put the kettle on.
I think so.
Yeah.
Fingers up.
Yeah. I'm really impressed because this is all, like, especially this, it's got ice on it.
Mm.
All right. Yeah, this is a dew shield and it's preventing the lens inside
from steaming up.
Oh. So I'm actually still getting
I don't know if you can see that, actually.
It's got crystal. I can see all the crystals.
Oh, yeah,
in
I could feel it. Yeah, can you hear that? That there, that's ice.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys can see that on the... Oh, you might be able to. Yeah, look. Can you see ice at the end of my left foot?
Wow, that Andromeda galaxy is just breathtaking. I mean, properly, like, wow. All right, it's a big grey smudge, but knowing what it is...
grey smudge.
It's like... Mm. I mean, it's just if I can get it in focus. There you go.
I'll point it at the sky, but I don't think
nothing's
going
to come.
Oh my god,
I can't
out.
Wait to photograph that.
Nothing's. No, can't see nothing. What a shame.
Have a little look for that eyepiece. See, in fact, let me just tweak and get it in the middle a bit, because it's just off centre. I use the little arrow keys to. I tell you what, I so cannot wait to see Saturn. Or Jupiter. They're both below the horizon at the moment. There you go, Andromeda Galaxy, right in the middle. Have a look through the camera, see how you get on with that one.
Oh, wow.
That's definitely a wow one, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can't see it with the naked eye by the looks of it. Or can you?
Cracking smudgy bit in the middle.
Yeah.
You can't see it, can you?
Whack the camera lens in there, see if that'll... If it's going to pick anything up, it'll pick that one up. If it'll be in focus, but
no.
It's not going to work, is it? No, never mind. I'm sure there'll be a way to do that at some point. I'll look into it.
Yeah, DSLR, I reckon.
Yeah, I think so. It'd be still photographed. I'd love to get a video of it. I should be able to do the moon when the moon comes up.
Yeah, that'd be good.
I don't think that's today. Right, so you're going to get a cup of tea?
Yeah, that's...
Okay, what time is it?
It's
10 to 9. It feels like about midnight because we've been outside in the dark for hours. This poor man is a bit chilly. But how was your evening, Austin?
Cold.
Very good.
It's very good. It's cold. Got some cracking photos.
He got some amazing photos. Can I show him one of your photos
in
my video?
Yeah.
This is one of Austin's...
I'll send them over.
Okay. All right, so this is one of Austin's photos. Well, I've had my first evening of stargazing with the new telescope, and I have to say, at first I was a little bit frustrated because I wasn't setting it up right. And then the North Star, which you've got to set everything up on, I kept losing it to the mist and it kept getting really faint. And when you look in the little receptacle to line it up, it lights up, and as soon as it lights up, it drowns out the North Star, so you couldn't find it. But I had a couple of attempts at the setup, and then like the third time, I got it spot on, and it started working really well. And literally, I'll just say, all right, go to wherever, and it'll be right smack bang center in the middle of the eyepiece. So I think I've sussed it out now. But the one thing that blew me away today was the Andromeda Galaxy. That was nice. You can see it's a galaxy. It's still a little grey smudge, but
it's a cracking smudge.
It was a cracking smudge. Honestly, if I get a DSLR body camera, just if I can get hold of a cheap DSLR camera body and a mount and stick that
you'll
on there,
you'll get yourself timed
exposure.
Cheaper EOS one. So is it EOS?
I just get an old EOS, you know, from 10 years ago or whatever. Because all you need is like a bulb setting. I presume. I've got to look this up. But,
yeah, I guess so.
And then do a long exposure. And I reckon I could get a cracking shot.
Yeah, because you're not
going to,
yeah.
I'm getting really excited now about the whole astrophotography side of things. Especially on a night like tonight. It's so still, so calm. And it's you can see the Milky Way. Unfortunately, I can't show you. I'd love to show you this stuff, but this even my infrared camera just wouldn't pick it up.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Anyway, what time is it? I might have another half hour out there just looking at astrological objects, astronomical objects. Apparently if you go to an astronomical society and start using the astrological words, you get punched. So I must learn the difference. Know the difference. Astrology and astronomy. It's the one with the N in it. Astronomy.
Well, good morning. It is 9:30 the next morning. I just got up. It was really, really cold last night. I had this little heater on. This little radiator running all night. And it was over there in the little footwell, but it wasn't enough to keep the cold away. It went down to about -3, I think. I was nice and warm under the duvet, because it's like a nice thick duvet, but you just sort of poke your head out and it was just like you could feel that ice on your face. And I'm gonna have a go opening the window. The last time I looked at this window, there was ice on it on the inside. So that's how cold it was. Let's have a look and see what's what. I've had the heaters running, so the ice is melting now. But it is, wow, it is really frosty looking out there. I'll show you. Wow. Yeah, that's wet. So there we go, that's what it looks like outside, and it's pretty, I'd say that's pretty frosty. You can't even see the trees across the way there because of the foggy frost. It's about -2 degrees outside at the moment, so I'm not going to be going out for a little while. I think I shall sit in here and make some breakfast and wake up a bit. I didn't sleep a lot last night. It was a bit too cold to sleep. And the other thing is I couldn't leave the warm air heating running, because it's, even with the thermostat, I'll show you, even with the thermostat like fully turned down, and you know, just on minimum, it's just either fully on or fully off. It doesn't switch on and off, you know, like a thermostat sort of central heating. And also, when I've left the van for any period of time with the gas bottle switched on, there's a very, very faint smell of gas. So I think I've got a very, very slight seepage of gas somewhere, which I'm going to see whether I can sort of discover it today. But I didn't like the idea of leaving the gas bottle turned on overnight because of that. So two things working against me. Right then, so cup of tea and a bit of breakfast. And then we'll see what's what.
I'm in the famous Austin van. Yeah. And I'll tell you what, it's so cold outside, it's like minus, it's been basically been minus one all day.
Look in the shade, like behind the caravans,
but it's
still frozen.
Oh yeah, it is still frozen. Yeah, on the floor by the side of the caravans, there's still frost on the floor.
But yeah, we've not really had any sun, have we?
Hopefully you can see that little blue thing on the floor, the blue and black thing. That's my fridge bag, or my cool bag. I've actually left it outside because it's cooler out there, because I've actually got some raw meat in. I've got some sausages. Austin, something made Austin's day earlier.
Oh no, last night, yeah, I mentioned that in the vlog this morning.
Oh.
Come on, what are you doing?
See,
Come on.
Austin got recognised.
Oh, yeah. Come on, you.
So, two chaps staying here. Two or three?
Two, yeah.
Two guys staying here.
Look, you're going to get.
And they recognised him. And just
or famous.
And did you give him a cup of tea?
We didn't know.
No.
They went off. They did ask me whether I wanted to have a pint.
Yeah.
But I did decline, but it's very nice of them. Yeah, so if you're watching this channel as well, thank you guys, it was nice to meet you.
it's quite cool when that happens, isn't it?
Yeah. I've had that a few times on sites now, I've bumped into quite a few people. They were watching Sandy's videos as well.
Oh, right, yeah,
Wiltshire
okay.
Man.
Yeah.
Yeah, they said they followed him. And he's obviously so you.
Yeah. Yeah, it's I've only been recognised a couple of times, and it's a bit weird when it happens. It's like, you know.
Here they go.
Because
it's like you're off the telly, isn't it? You go. Oh, yeah. You're.
You never know how to. Never know how to respond though. It's like,
no,
oh,
I know.
Hello.
Hello.
I know when Sharon and I got a lovely couple live around the corner from me, literally a couple of streets away. And the first time I met Terry, I was working on the van outside my house, and there was this guy stood there with a dog, and I was backing up over the pavement. He said, "No, it's all right, go on." And then, so I get onto the grass, I get out of the van, and he comes up to me, he says, "You don't know me, but I feel I know quite a lot about you." And it turns out he'd been watching the Rickvanman channel, which is really cool.
Yeah, lovely pair.
And, lovely pair. I love Terry and Sharon. They're great. Really lovely, lovely, lovely couple. And I had some guy who was a window cleaner.
Oh, right.
And it was a couple of years ago when I had the white van. He was in my car park, and he came up to me and he said, "You got a YouTube channel on YouTube?" I said. I might have.
Yeah.
And apparently he'd looked up one of the videos on how I did the shower system in the van,
because
he was looking at water systems for his for his business. And he spotted the video there, which is really cool.
Oh, that was useful then.
No. In fact, Wiltshire man Sandy, I bumped into him in Wicks.
I was
shopping in Wicks, and this guy comes up to me. He says, "Are you Rick?" "Hello." As soon as he said his name, I thought, "Ah, I know that channel because I watch it." So, but Sandy lives in the same town as me, so
yeah, he ain't far away.
No, he's not too far away. No.
It's a funny world, isn't it?
Yeah, it turns out to be a small world. You know, Steve from Steve's Kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
When he came over to visit, it turns out he was staying at his uncle's house in Highworth.
Oh right.
And I joked. I said, "Oh, because my brother-in-law lives in Highworth, and before my sister died, it was they lived." In Highworth.
All right.
And I just jokingly said, "Don't laugh." I said, "What's your uncle's name? I bet my brother-in-law will know him." And he said their name, and I said, "I know them." And he'd come all the way from Australia to stay at his uncle's house. Turns out, I knew his uncle from like when I was about five, because we used to go around there a lot. And his uncle and his missus was best mates with my sister and brother-in-law. And they still are best mates, or brother-in-law, they're still best mates.
Yeah,
and they live a stone's throw, literally in the same street. It was just, talk about a small world.
Well, that's how it is, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Law of attraction or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was just like, it was such a surprise. It was really funny.
Yeah, it was like that. But same with Sharon and Terry. I never met him before.
Mm.
When I was helping you with your van.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah, you're really quiet.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, and nobody's helping you with your van.
That's right, they come
around
and visit.
They come around a cup of tea. It's like, they say, hello, hello. Like, yeah. We've known them for years. And I've never met them face to face.
Yeah. Really that's just because they're a really nice couple. They talk to you like you've known them for years. Really, really.
You're going to like this, guys.
Yeah.
Don't let them cut this bit out, mind. You have to leave this bit in. they are cracking people. Mm. Yeah, we'll have to invite them around on a camp one day.
Yeah, that'd be good. Mm. Yeah, I'll tell you, wait till the summer. I'll get Damon out here with his telescope. I'll get my telescope out as well. We'll have like a stargazing camp. That'd be good.
I'll get that out.
By then you'll have perfected taking pictures at night of telescopes, and then you can
in the dark.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. I look forward to that.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so it's sort of dusk, turning evening. You can see Venus up there in the sky. There's Austin waving. That little star up in the sky, that's Venus. I'm not going to be getting the telescope out tonight because it's going to be foggy. But the forecast isn't very good, although at the moment it's looking okay. The sky up there is pretty clear. But I know last night when I had the telescope out, you could only see really objects above. Everything around the edges was kind of foggy. So anyway, we're going to have an evening of chilling out, I think. Damon's here. He's just arrived. He's got Barney with him. And so we managed to get three pictures in a row. So we've got Damon's van there, we've got Austin's van there, and we've got my little van over there. Oh, he's got an icicle. Good grief.
Solid ice stuck on the side there.
Look at that. That's pretty impressive. Big blob of ice down the bottom there. Wow. It's quite peaceful here, isn't it?
It's nice.
Really nice and chilled out. All the people we've met so far have been all kind of quite chilled out.
Emphasis on chill.
Yeah. Yeah. I need to wear my big jacket today because I know it's going to be cold. Well, I wore it yesterday. Yeah, go on up. Pop in. Oh, right then.
Come on, hello. Silly.
Hello, just don't jump up at me, alright? I'll make a fuss of you. Just don't jump up. Don't jump up. Don't jump up. What are you like? I've got your collar now. Ah, so you can't jump up if you want to.
Come on, get down here.
Right, anyway, we're gonna kind of chill out and have an evening of doing whatever we're gonna do. See you soon. Well, good morning. This is day two. It's the morning, Sunday morning, going home today. So I've packed everything. Well, I've packed all my window bits up and everything now. We didn't do a great deal last night. It was a little bit too cold, lots of frost around everywhere again. And we did go for a nice long walk. Austin took Ellie and Damon took Barney. And we took the dogs out. There's this big sort of forest road that goes up to civilization. And we walked along this road and we turned all the torches out and it was absolutely pitch black. And Damon's got this see in the dark thing. It's like an infrared night vision scope, and we were sort of looking around and it was amazing. It was just, I mean, you look at the stars with it, all the stars and everything that come out. It's just an incredible bit of technology. And I'm wondering if there's a way I can incorporate something like that with a telescope. I might be able to see things flying around on the moon or something, you know, that would be quite good. But I shall look into that at a later date. Couldn't get the telescope out last night, it was too overcast. And the weather predictions were right. It was around the time I should have set the scope up, it was really clear, and I was sort of thinking, maybe I should set this thing up. But then within half an hour it had all clouded over, so I was right not to do it, because it's kind of half an hour setup time. So you know, you've got to be sure that the sky is going to be clear. And I'm just getting ready to do a bit of breakfast. So I've got some sausages and some mushrooms and some garlic mushrooms with sausage. I think that'd be nice. So anyway, I'm just gonna have my breakfast, and then I'm gonna probably sort of have a natter and a chat with the guys before I head off home. So I have no idea how long this video is, but it's probably quite a long one again. But I'll cut all the waffly bits out, because it's, you know, the waffly bits can be a bit dull to watch. So but hopefully this has been a slightly interesting video. So that's it from me. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a great rest of the day, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.
Thanks for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to thumbs up. Here is a button you can press if you want to subscribe to the channel. Here is my latest video, and here is a video based upon your browsing habits.